Hello everyone, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to Morning Tales for 25th August 2019. Today, as I said, I will be talking about the questions that left unanswered in the last video. So we talked about HR Khan committee recommendations which SEBI has adopted. We talked about cross-selling, and today I'm going to start with explaining both these things and then we'll move forward and talk about a lot of questions. I'm also going to show you a special video today which has been released by World Bank. So stick around, watch that video. It's going to be really great, really exciting. Okay, so let's start with HR Khan committee's recommendations on FIIs. And according to these recommendations, the following changes have been made and adopted by SEBI. Number one, with respect to FIIs, foreign institutional investors, there used to be three categories of FIIs which have now been changed to two. So they've been reduced to two in order to make it easier for FIIs to get recognized and also to invest in India. There have been some buyback norms which have been changed, the purpose being to make it simpler for FIIs as well as NBFCs and housing finance companies to buy back their shares in case they want to. So what is the new norm which has been recommended and accepted? The new norm is that if there is a listed firm which has HFCs and NBFCs as subsidiaries and they want to go for buyback of shares, and their standalone debt equity ratio should be less than 2:1 or equal to 2:1, and the debt equity ratio of subsidiaries, that is HFCs and NBFCs, can be as high as 6:1, because the purpose is to allow them to buy back their shares in case, even if their debt equity ratio is very high. Okay, the next is credit rating agencies have been asked to and also given more powers in order to have the entire financial details of companies, so that the recommendations or the crediting given by credit rating agencies is more reliable. Okay, now there's something called as broad-based funds, and the older rule said that in case you want to apply for broad-based funds, you have to have more than 20 members under the FII. So if an FII wants to be called as a broad-based fund, it needs to have at least 20 member investors, which has now been removed completely. So 20 member requirement has been completely removed. This is not very important, very theoretical in nature. I will be talking about the HR Khan committee recommendations separately as well in finance current affairs. And the most important one is reward to whistleblowers, where I believe a question can be asked specifically in phase one, which says that an announcement or a reward of 1 crore or 10% of amount which has been collected through the whistleblower's whistle can be given to the whistleblower. So if let's say 10 crores is collected, or let's say 15 crores is collected, so either 1 crore or 10 crore, 10% of 15 crore, which will be 1.5 crore, lower amount is 1 crore, so 1 crore can be given to the whistleblowers, so as to incentivize the whistleblowers to come forward and file complaints. Now, some things related to cross-selling, because I asked a question in the last session on Morning Tales, wherein I asked you to tell me what cross-selling is. It's a process or method through which an additional product or service is sold to an existing customer. Let's say this is a bank and this is a customer, and he already holds an account in this bank. So he already holds an account in this bank. Now he comes to the bank in order to do his regular transactions, and the bank manager or the other representatives, let's say he goes up to them and he says that you already have an account in bank. Why don't you go for an insurance? Because you are running, let's say, a company which has a lot of assets and there's a threat of fire. Why don't you go for a insurance of your company, complete asset insurance? Why don't you go for a credit card in case you need some working capital immediately tomorrow? You can use your credit cards. I need credit cards in order to pay for the softwares that I have to buy from, let's say, other countries like the US. So there are a lot of foreign softwares, a lot of US-based softwares that I have to buy on a regular basis, and I need to pay for them through credit cards only, because debit cards are not accepted by them. Now, that kind of cross-selling, which is done by banks and which is useful for the bank as well as for the customer, is called as cross-selling. Basically, selling additional products once a customer has already taken an account or opened an account in your bank. Okay, it can be as simple as insurance, credit cards, retirement plans, personal line of credit, or saving products like certificate of deposit. Let's come to the next question, or the first question for today. In fact, the question is, what is the name of the first of its kind program launched by Kiran Rijiju and Baijung Bhutia? Kiran Rijiju is the sports minister of India now, and Baijung Bhutia to train people about basic survival techniques. It has been called as a Operation Blue Freedom, or Blue Freedom, and it will be using the army veterans. So all these retired army veterans who are looking for a job, or who have a lot of skills but they're not being able to utilize their skills more effectively, will be used under Operation Blue Freedom. They'll be training regular civilians in the art of survival, in the art of carrying out basic necessities in order to stay more fit. The next question is, with which company has West Bengal's Forest Department and Worldwide Fund India partnered to protect the Sundarban forests? So the answer to this question is D, Discovery India. So Worldwide Fund and West Bengal government have partnered with Discovery India in order to protect the Sundarban forest. A very brief chart about, or the map on Sundarban forest, in case you don't know about it. So this is Kolkata, and this is the international line between India and Bangladesh, and these are the Sundarban forest, as you can see here. So almost 2/3 of the forest lies in Bangladesh and about 1/3 of it lies in India, and it is already declared as a national park, as well as parts of it have already been declared as wildlife sanctuaries in order to protect them. It's a mangrove forest, in case you don't know about it, and it's famous for white tigers. What is the percentage of cases of leprosy in India according to WHO's data? Now, in 2009, India had been declared as free from leprosy, but India has again got into clutches of leprosy because of low focus provided on this disease. And now, according to WHO's data, 66% of global cases of leprosy are coming from India, which is very high and needs to be controlled immediately. Just like we have controlled polio, we need to work on leprosy as well. Okay, the next question is, which state has been ranked first by National Health Mission for implementation of free medicine scheme? Now, National Health Mission had implemented a free medicine scheme, and states had adopted it in their own ways, and Rajasthan has been ranked first in this. Which city has topped the Knight Frank's Prime Global Cities Index 2019? The answer is Berlin, and this index is to provide the cost of living. The higher the cost of living is, the more the rank of a city is, the standard of living and the cost of living. What is the rank of Delhi and Mumbai? This is the question for you today. What is the rank of Delhi and what is the rank of Mumbai in this Knight Frank's Prime Global Cities Index? You have to search for it. Okay. The next question is, dash of potential economic growth can be affected due to water pollution. According to World Bank's Quality Unknown, the Invisible Water Crisis Report. Now, a question that can be framed and asked from you is, what is the name of the report by World Bank which focuses on water pollution and water crisis, which is building up in the entire world? The name of the report is Quality Unknown, the Invisible Water Crisis. And what percentage or what ratio of potential economic growth can be affected? The answer is A, 1/3 or 1/3. Now let's have a look at the video which was released by World Bank. A very moving video, and that's why I wanted to show it to you. Okay. Thank you. and a lot of facts other than the fact that I discussed with you are provided in the video. I want you to watch this video again if you want to and note down all those facts. Any of those facts can be asked in the examination. Okay. The next question is, how much relief from the duty demand will be given to SSE if the amount is up to 50 lakh according to Sabka Vishwas Legacy Dispute Resolution Scheme? Now, let us talk about briefly about this particular scheme, which has been launched and will be implemented from 1st September 2019 till 1st September 2019 to 31st December 2019. Okay, that is the time period. And under this, two major taxes, legacy service tax and central excise, which have now been subsumed under GST, are to be taken up. So all those pending cases about or related with the legacy service tax and central excise cases will be taken up. Under this, if your amount which is under dispute is less than 50 lakh, then 70% of the duty demand can be offered as a relief. 70% if the amount under dispute is less than 50 lakh. If it is more than 50 lakh, then 50% of the amount can be provided as a relief. Now, this is the major recommendation of under the scheme which is available. Okay, I would want you to again go back to the scheme again and discuss and read about it, because I will be taking this up under the government scheme section as well. A very important one, because a new one, so we need to talk about it in details as well, and I will be taking it up very soon, probably in the next class. Let us pick up this particular scheme only, Sabka Vishwas Legacy Dispute Resolution Scheme, and talk about it in detail. So go read about it and then we will have a talk about it. Okay, the last question for today is, which actor has topped the Forbes highest paid actors 2019? The answer is E, Dwayne Johnson, at about 65 billion US dollars. Okay, that's the amount of money or net worth that this actor has. Indian actor in the top 10 is Akshay Kumar at the rank of 4th. So this was all about today's morning tales. I hope you liked it. If you did, if you found it important, and if you found it interesting, do not forget to subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon and share it with your friends so that more and more people can watch it and learn something new every morning. Okay, all the very best. Take care. Have a nice day.